tales of our pal Piggley. Ireland is the world he loves so well. It wriggles out of spots and are downright stickly. How he does that, only he can tell. Piggley, Bernie, Molly, and Dan, and never miss a chance to have too much fun. In Tara or Rallo, lots of excitement for everyone. Curiosity's in a hurry, leaving no time to stop and think. The line between wild and crazy gets blurry.
Jiggers!
The adventures of Piggly Winks. Something in the way his eyes start blazing tells us he's on to a brand new plan. His lips curl up, it's downright amazing. Looking for mischief, well, he's your man. Piggly, Fernie, Molly, and Dan, and never miss a chance to have too much fun. In Tara, Aralu, lots of excitement for everyone.
Jiggers!
You go to bed just to wake up early, to get in trouble or on the brink. The line between wild and crazy gets blurry.
Jiggers!
The adventures of Piggly Wings.
Grandpa!
You're stopping me, Maggie.
Sorry, but guess what happened at school today? Everyone in my whole class has to read The Rallo Rocketeers. They couldn't believe it when I told them my very own grandpa wrote it.
The Rallo Rocketeers. Oh, me first. And still me favorite.
Everyone else is going to see what a great writer you are.
Why, thank you, Meg. And next week at your school's variety show, everyone is going to see what a great dancer you are. I bet you've been working like mad, creating a wonderful dance for that show, haven't you?
No, I haven't really started yet. Dancing is easy for me, and I already kind of know what I'm going to do.
Oh, I see. Well, it is nice to have a natural gift like that, Meg. Then again, there's always room for improvement. That was a lesson I had to learn the hard way.
Didn't you always have to learn your lessons the hard way, Grandpa?
I suppose I did. But now this lesson came from a very unusual source. This lesson actually came from a teacher.
Lads! Have you heard the news? Mr. Hornsby has gone up to Dublin to play his fiddle at a big fair or something. He's not here today! Jakers, that's great news! Come on, lads, let's go home!
Wait! Just because there's no Mr. Hornsby doesn't mean there's no school.
Oh, but Dannon, you can't have school without a teacher.
Of course not. That's why we'll probably have a substitute teacher.
I was thinking that as well.
Hector?
There's nothing more fun than playing tricks on a substitute teacher. Let's go and see if he's here. I don't see him here, Hector. Perfect. Now I can go and set up the trick.
Are you sure we're going to have a substitute teacher today, Dannon?
Yes, Farley, I'm sure.
Me dad told me that one time he had a substitute teacher and he and his friends pretended to be each other for the whole day.
Now that's funny, but I'll bet you and Fernie are too chicken to do something like that.
And that's it then. I'm Fernie.
And I'm Piggley.
Good morning. I'm Mr. McHoof. I'll be your teacher while Mr. Hornsby is away. He's told me so much about all of you, I feel as though I know you already.
I can't wait until he sits down on that chair.
Of course, I could use a little help. What with this being my first day here and everything. You there, what's your name, young man?
Who? Me?
According to the seating chart, used to be Hector, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Fine then, Hector. Would you come up here, please? I've always found it useful to have someone in the class assist me on the first day. So, why don't you go ahead and take a seat there?
Oh, I'd rather stand, sir.
Did you see that? And that is funny. It goes... You know, I am going to play tricks like that on all my sheep friends.
So now, let's see who else is here today. You must be Danon.
That's right, sir.
And you must be Piggly Winks.
That's right. I'm Piggly.
Mr. Hornsby told me to make sure I keep a close eye on you.
He did?
Oh, yes. He went to school with your father when they were young. Isn't that right?
Yes, he did.
I've forgotten what Mr. Hornsby told me. What is your father's name again?
Mr. Winks.
I mean his first name, Piggly.
Mr. I don't know, I tell you. I don't know. He's not my father, and I'm not Piggly.
Then maybe you want to take your own seat now, Bernie?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Right away, sir. I'm on my way.
I'll tell you, Piggly, I like a class that's creative. If you're all planning to drop your pencils at the same time, you might want to rethink it.
It didn't take a room full of geniuses to figure out that Mr. McHoof was a very wise man.
All right then, class. Who here loves a good story? Does anyone here have a story about something funny or heroic or strange that happened to someone in their family? How about you, Danny?
What? I suppose I do have a story or two.
Great. I'd love to hear one.
Well, my favorite story is about my Aunt Gertie. She has a chicken on her farm who really loves pie. One time, the chicken actually stole a pie right off her windowsill. And me Aunt Gertie spent the whole afternoon chasing that crazy bird all over the place.
That's quite a story, Danon. But tell me, what did your Aunt Gertie look like while she was chasing that chicken?
Oh, me Aunt Gertie has feet the size of a small country and arms as long as a month of Sundays. So when she took off after that chicken, her feet were slapping and her arms were flapping.
And how did she sound?
Oh, her voice was like fingernails on a chalkboard. And she just kept yelling, "Hey, chicken, 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 hey, a chicken!"
Yes, it is. And you made it even funnier when you described how your aunt looked and sounded. Those kind of details really make a story come alive. Who else has a story to share with us?
That Mr. McHoof was good, all right. He soon had everyone in the class eager to tell their tale.
Papa used to be the blacksmith for the fastest horses in
the world. Fernie shared a story about the day 10 horses came into his father's blacksmith shop. Mr. McHoof guided his description of the shop until we could almost smell the thick odor of sweaty horses and dry hay. Then Hector told a tale.
There I was, in the apple orchard, being attacked by a giant, massive goat.
And we could see its angry eyes blazing and feel its hot breath snorting. Before we knew it, the school day was over.
I'm sorry, children. That's all the time we have for storytelling today. Your assignment for the weekend is to write a 2-page story about someone in your family. We'll read them aloud on Monday. That's it then. Class dismissed.
That weekend began with none of us giving a second thought to our homework. But by Sunday afternoon, thoughts of homework and Monday morning were beginning to interfere with our game.
I've asked me hearties,
It's time to dig for buried treasure!
I'm afraid you'll have to dig without me, Captain Piggley.
What's wrong with you, Swabby? Do you want to walk the plank?
No, I want to walk home and get started on my homework.
Jacob Stannin, you never start your homework this early.
I know, but I want to give myself plenty of extra time to write a great story for Mr. McHoof.
But Dannin...
Oh, well, I better be going as well.
No, don't go, Fernie. You can write your story later. It's easy.
Oh, well, it's easy for you, but writing a story takes me a long time. Wait for me, Donald. Wait.
We'll see you in the morning, Piggley.
Bernie, 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 my wild Irish sheep.
Look. It's the first flower of spring, and it's only November. It's a miracle. Come on, you sweet little Irish seat cover. Have a smell. For me. Oh, you silly boy. You shouldn't have. I mean, they're just gorgeous. Ah, Wiley, get over here. Just look what Bernie gave me, and you didn't, my own ugly. Here, smell. Just wanted you to smell you did not get me. I don't think...
You're a funny guy. Who knew?
Home so soon, son? I thought you were out with Dannin and Fernie.
Yeah, they went home to start their homework.
Why don't you go and get started on your homework as well?
It's okay, I can do it later. It's easy. Can I help you with anything, Dad?
No, thank you. I would... Molly!
Go on, get away!
All right now, Molly. Just calm down and hold still. It's only a dragonfly.
Ooh, he's pretty. Can I keep him?
Well, I imagine he already has a home of his own, Molly.
Goodbye, Mr. Dragonfly.
You want me to go with you to find some other bugs, Molly?
I think it's best that you get started on that homework, Piggley.
Yes, Dad.
Now, I really did intend to get started on my homework. But there was so much to be done before I could begin. My new Buck Bravo comic book had arrived and needed to be read. At one point, I actually collected paper and pencil and sat down at my desk to write. But I couldn't resist making a paper airplane or two.
Piggley, you coming?
Early that evening, after a fine dinner to fill my belly, I was finally ready to get to work.
Let's see now. It was a cool autumn day on Ralu Farm. It was a cool, crisp autumn day on Ralu Farm. Mr. McCuff will like that. I had just come home from playing with me friends. From an afternoon of high adventure with me loyal pals. When suddenly, me little sister Molly began screaming like a banshee. I'll probably get an A+ on this assignment. I ran over to see what was wrong. And there was a...
Piggley, I hope your homework is finished, love. Your favorite radio show is coming on.
Scary Monster Theater. Yes, Mommy. I'm almost done. I still have a whole page to fill. And there was a dragonfly. Me dad caught the dragonfly. It was very, 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 very friendly.
Piggley, you coming?
Yes, Dad. Molly was okay. We let the dragonfly go. Everyone was happy. The end. There. 2 pages. Coming, Dad.
Wiley, a harvest moon.
What could be more romantic?
Harvest moon up close. Wiley, you think of everything.
There's something wrong. I can't see anything. Maybe it's the wrong eye. No, this isn't any good either. Wiley, this telescope is no good at... Wiley? Wiley, where did you go? Wiley? Why is that raccoon smiling at me like that?
Monday morning, we arrived at school to find everyone excited about the homework assignment.
Let's settle down and get right to it. I hope you all enjoyed working on your stories this weekend. Piggley, I'd like you to start us off.
Oh, yes, sir. It was a cool, crisp autumn day on Riley Farm. I had just come home from an afternoon of high adventure with me loyal pals. Suddenly, me little sister Molly began screaming like a banshee. I ran over to see what was wrong, and there, flying around me sister's head, was...
Go on, Piggley. It's quite nice so far.
Flying around me sister's head was a dragon! That's right, a real, live, fire-breathing dragon! He was as big as our house. There he was, flying around me sweet little sister's head. Molly ran to the safety of me dad's arms! But the dragon kept throwing his flaming breath all over the yard. So, with great courage and bravery, me dad ran to the trough and scooped out a bucket full of water. With a mighty toss, me dad threw the water right into the dragon's huge gaping mouth. But then he started to wag his huge, scaly tail. The dragon, that is, not me dad. And he roared onto his back like a big, happy, young puppy dog. That dragon wasn't really mean after all. He was just thirsty. The end.
Well, well, that was excellent.
Thank you, sir.
I'll take your papers now.
Me papers? You know, that isn't really the whole story there. Those are just, me notes. You see, the dragon ate me real homework this morning, right before school.
I see. You know, Mr. Hornsby told me that you have a lot of talent, Piggley.
He did?
Oh, yes. And I thought your story was very imaginative and exciting.
Thank you. Does that mean I'm going to get an A+ on the assignment?
I'm afraid I'm going to have to give you an F, Piggley.
What?
You see, you didn't do the assignment.
But I have talent.
Yes, you have been given a gift, but it's up to you to do something with it. And that young man takes work. Work that you did not do.
But...
You may take your seat now. Who would like to go next?
Oh, I brooded about that for the rest of the day.
not fair. I have talent and all that. Just doesn't like me, that's all. She's being mean to me on purpose. Sorry, Finnegan. I don't really care anyway. Mr. McCuff isn't a real teacher. He's just a substitute teacher.
Ah, but I finally had to face the truth. And the truth was, I hadn't worked very hard. And deep inside, I knew that I could do much better. So, fortified with some fresh new paper, I got down to the serious business of writing.
And you've been writing ever since, right, Grandpa?
That's right, Meg. But I never took my talent for granted again. You see, even though I had been given a gift, it was really up to me to make the most of it.
So, I guess you're saying that I should get busy and work on my dance for the show next week, huh, Grandpa?
I don't remember saying that exactly. But I do think it's a grand idea. So, why don't we both get busy? I hope you're making the most of your talents, too.